up to the Fern Grotto, which is something up there that is well worthwhile seeing. And I know each and all of you folks will enjoy this trip. This river here is called the Wailua River, which has an average depth of about 20 feet deep. Salt water goes up 4 miles, navigable trees. This river here, which is called the Wailua River, comes from Mount Waialeale. You can see that mountain there on our left side, right up between those two small mountains. That mountain there is called Mount Waialeale, which rains between 400 to 700 inches of rain a year. Mount Waialeale has a height of 5,500 feet, and the Wailua River is right in the center part of this beautiful mountain. We have 5 big rivers on this island here, but the Wailua River is the largest of all. When I told you that it rains 400 to 700 inches of rain in a year, in 1963 we experienced one of the biggest rains that we ever experienced here. It rained 26 inches in 12 hours, and this whole place here was just a mess of water. Famous Fern Grotto. As we go up, you can see this beautiful park here on the right, which has been known as the Kamwali Park. This is the park where King Kamwali used to live, and he was the man that gave this beautiful island, Kauai, to King Kamehameha. King Kamehameha did not conquer this island. He tried twice but did not succeed in his mission. King Kamwali, knowing that Kamehameha will still come back, built 8 double canoes. When all those canoes were ready, he and his small group of men sailed for the island of Oahu and landed on the beach of Waianae, where he was taken prisoner. King Kamehameha accepted the island of Kauai in the year of 1810. Word was sent to all of the islands that Kamehameha was the ruler of Hawaii. The people on Kauai, from that time on, always said, Imua, Imua, Kamehameha. Go forward, our honorable king. But this is one island he did not conquer. From that time on, we always named this river here, the Wailua River, always as the king's highway.
Oh,
Now as we go up a little further, there you can see this pili grass below the Puliahu Heiau. This pili grass was known to the Hawaiians for building of the thatch huts, also hula skirts. Many, many Hawaiians used to make cushions out of it, mattresses, also pillows. But today, all of this pili grass has been forgotten. On your right and on your left, these beautiful trees that hangs right down to the water are called a hau. The big branches, that's what we use to make our outriggers. Small branches, we make our fishnet floaters. And the bark, we make our rope, hula skirts, and also runners. It has a yellow blossom. This yellow blossom stays yellow all day. When evening comes, it turns orange. The next morning it turns red before it falls. Before, in the olden days, the Hawaiian girls used to wear this flower on their hair and invite people into their homes and also pictures taken. But today, the hibiscus has taken it over and became known as our invitational flower of Hawaii.
Oh,
we go up a little further, on our left side, you can see this beautiful open green pasture land. Once before, this place was used by people, food crops, but today it's another pasture. You can see where my finger point, there's a little rock there that stands on its left. That rock there is called the Sister Rock. Saying long time ago, there was a man that used to live on the west side of this island who was a great kahuna. He used to worship to all types of idols, but one day he heard that there were two idols of power, idols that could heal people or heal people. And he wanted to get hold of it, but trusted no one except his two children. He woke them up one early morning, told them all what he heard, and asked them to go and steal those idols for him. Both brother and sister had to promise their father that they will keep it a secret, and left home that early morning, and were seen one late evening around this area here that we still call Mount Kapu, the Forbidden Mountain. Both brother and sister were seen around there by people one late evening, but no one know what happened to them. They never returned home. Their bodies were never been found or heard of. People went out looking for them day after day, but no one could find trace of neither brother nor sister. So in memory of the sister, they call this little rock here, in her memory, the Sister Rock. Later on, they made up a little story for her. They said, whenever we see any white bird that circles any part of this valley, this white bird will always come back to take care of the Sister Rock up to this day. It is just a legend. Vines dangle from trees, and small waterfall gracefully flows from above the cave, and the lacy ferns hang from the walls of this park. Now, with the help of nature's acoustics, members of the Smith family will sing for you the Hawaiian wedding song, Ke Kala.
Mm-hmm.
here we are, in this famous fern grove. This place here was used as a temple many, many years ago. The Hawaiians used to use this place for agricultural purpose, praying to the god Lono. The name of this place here has only three words, and the name is called Mama Akua Lono. The Hawaiian people, who are farmers, used to live all in this area here, from right down the both sides of the river up to Mount Wailua. They are the ones that raise food crops for the people below. They had 6 days before full moon and 6 days after full moon to come up here and worship. When time comes, they eat full the type of food that they're gonna plant. When they're all full and satisfied, they put one small portion of their food in a little calabash and only their way up to this famous place and place their little calabash on this altar here and pray to their god, asking him for big crop, good harvest, and a prosperous year. The meaning, Mama, is sure eat well. Akua means God. Lono the full moon God. That's why the Hawaiians, they always say, do not couple with this place. That means, do not spoil it. There was a man who was going to Ke'e, and this man here thought of going up to Waikapalai to see this cave. When he saw two girls, one of them was combing the other's hair. They were singing, their songs were beautiful. And when this man saw this, he got so excited, he ran home and told all his friends and people. They all came to see. He was embarrassed, and he waited days and days until one day he saw that these two girls were going back into this little place, Waikanaloa. He followed them and saw them going to his cave and ran home. He ran home and told all his friends what had happened. They all came, and one group went on the top and one below. They watched, and sure enough, they saw these two girls transform themselves into mermaids. Those that saw them at Waikanaloa said, if the gods want them to be that way, let's let them be that way. From that time on, Waikapalai and Waikanaloa was known as the place of the mermaids.
Oh,
Now, folks, look up here. You can see there's a little head of a Menehune. There was a man, a Menehune, who had three sons in Anahola. He used to live in the valley of Anahola. Menehunes always did like opie, or we call it shrimp. One night, he wanted his children to help him to get some opie. And it was just before the full moon to come up. He got his children and gave each one a calabash to collect his opie. He looked around, he couldn't find one of his boys. And he got mad and made a curse. If his son was somewhere around, he hoped that his son would stay where he is. And his son was way up on his mountain here. And Kalalea, he was looking down at the family picking opies. The father picked all the opies he could. When the moon came up, he looked around for his son. He couldn't find his son. And he made a curse again and went out to look for him. He saw his boy looking down the river. His curse became so powerful that it fell upon him. That's why you can always see father looking at son, son looking at the river. From then on, people always point to both father and son who made the curse many, many years back.
Okay, everybody, put up your right hand.
Yeah.
I do, you all swore me, you just volunteered to do the hula. Now, we're going to do the lazy man hula, sitting down. All you got to do is put up your right hand, your left hand under your right elbow, wave it back and forth. Here's your palm tree. Okay, your coconut is your head, your fingers fluttering down is your raindrop, and right next to you is a big drip. To the real old Hawaiian tune, Clementine. Okay, everybody. You don't have one, borrow one. There's plenty extras. All you men, put up your hands. Okay, just checking out if you know you men. Okay, put your hands down. Okay, now all the mahus. If you don't know what is that, never put up your hand. Because if you put up your hand, we have to call this boat the ferry boat. Okay, man, here we go. I'm a suitcase. Chance not to get even. I'm a
Magnavox Astro.
Thank you. That's the lazy man hula.
There's another big image here on our left side as we go west. It looks like a lady pointing. That's what we call Victoria. Her finger is pointing up towards Nawiluwili. That's why they always say, she points at it and says, if you have any children that are naughty, and you want to remember that name of our beautiful harbor, name the child Willie and say, now Willie Willie, be good.
Oh.
trip is coming to an end now. We hope you folks have enjoyed this little trip here with us, as we've enjoyed having you folks being with us. When you get back home, tell your friends about this little island here of Kauai. Of course, don't forget that real old Hawaiian name is Smith on the Waino River. That'll make no exceptions. You can't go wrong. The rest of our Smith family, we'd like to bid all of you a very big aloha.